Hello everyone, my name is Saartje from Haka met Saar and I'd like to welcome you to this video in which I will show you a step-by-step tutorial of how to crochet along with a jacaranda crochet along. I will be using US United States crochet terms. The jacaranda is a tablecloth pattern designed by Haaksteek, which is the artistic name of Iman van der Kraan. She designed this pattern to mirror the beauty of the jacaranda trees. They are a gorgeous blooming tree found in tropical and subtropical regions. In her case, I was in Egypt, and every spring this tree would bloom alongside the roads, and it was always a beautiful sight. This crochet along will start on the 1st of February and will last for 11 weeks. You will be able to find the patterns on Ravelry and on Facebook. So make sure you join at least on one of, or both of course, of these. And you can find a link in this video and in the comments as well. I will post that later. This pattern will be suitable for adventurous beginners. And this means that even if you know only the basic stitches, if you follow the instruction video combined with the pattern, you should be able to do this. Of course, I will record a video of each round and I will try to show you every stitch in as much detail as possible. And this makes it possible for people who don't read patterns to join in as well. Of course, I do advise you to also take a peek at the pattern because this is really how I learned crochet. I did Sophie's Universe with Esther Dijkstra's great instruction videos. And this way I learned how to read a pattern as well. You never know, maybe this happens to you as well, and you come out of this crochet along even knowing how to read a pattern, which of course opens many doors for everyone, so I would really advise that as well. The pattern itself was designed to be crocheted with Alize Diva yarn. You saw a little bit of the yarn in the beginning of the video as well. This is a gorgeous, really pretty microfiber acrylic yarn. So it's not cotton, but it has the feel of it a little bit. It's a little bit shiny, just the right amount. It's not too shiny, but it's also not too toned down. It's very, very nice. And it's very, very nice to work with. It's really a joy to work with. You can buy this yarn through me as well on my Facebook page, Haak aan met Saar. And I'll share the link with you in the video and in the comments. If you crochet with this particular yarn and a 3 mm hook, your work should come out around 90 centimeters, at 90 centimeters, so a square of 90 centimeters. Of course, if your tension is a little bit different, or if you use a different yarn or a different hook, it will come out different in size. But don't worry, it will still be beautiful. So if you decide to not use this particular brand of yarn, but a thicker yarn, for example, in that case it will be bigger. It might be a meter and a half by a meter and a half or something like that, with a 6 mm hook, for example. It will still be beautiful. It will be a nice labgan or something. So you can make it with any yarn, and do share your pictures as well to let us know how it turns out. You need the yarn, of course, for this crochet along. And next to the yarn, you also need a 3 mm hook. Any type of hook will do, of course. I like to use this hook with a grip. Sorry, a 3 mm hook, and some stitch markers, and a pair of scissors. Any scissors will do. As for stitch markers, anything will do. I like to use stitch markers, I think they're cute, but of course any piece of scrap yarn or a paper clip or anything will do for in place of a stitch marker. The pattern calls for at least 5 different colors. Of course, this is nothing that you have to do. You can always choose more colors. You can use scraps of yarn that's still in your cupboard. You can use one grade of yarn, one color, or two. feel free to be creative and use the colors that you want to use. As I go through the rounds, I will tell you which color I am changing to. So it's A, B, C, D, or E, and it will also be clearly stated in the pattern. Don't forget to mark your yarn beforehand. I will still do that. I'll just write something on the label as well, so you know which is A, which is B, etc. Because after a while you might get confused, and of course you don't want to do that. And especially if you don't have an unlimited supply of yarn, to not have a problem in the end with the amount of yarn that you have, it's really important to mark so that you don't use too much of one ball of yarn. In my case, I chose a different palette from any kit that we created or any that Haakstek used for her patterns. I like to use something different. I like my crochet items to be unique. So I chose these colors, which is two balls of this off-white, which is nearly white, but not exactly. It's more like a pearly white. Two balls of light gray, like a silvery gray. Two balls of a very nice deep purple, as you can see. And to add to these colors, I chose a lila color. It's a really nice light purple color, and a smoky gray, which is really a quite dark shade of gray. I think these colors together will make a very nice tablecloth, especially since I usually don't use these kind of colors. I usually go for pinks and stuff like that. So I think this is going to be a good experience for me. And I think you know all there is to know about what's coming. I hope this introduction video has piqued your interest in this crochet along, and I of course hope to see you on the 1st of February when we start this journey together. Thank you for watching and have a great crochet day. Round 1. I have my first color of yarn, which is yarn A, color A. And we're going to start our crochet along with a magic circle or a chain 4 closed with a slip stitch. I always use the chain 4 option. I'm just going to make a slip knot like this. Get your hook in there and tighten. I'm going to start by making a chain 4. So I'm just going to make 1, 2, 3, and 4. And then we're going to look for that first chain here and insert your hook. Get your yarn through and slip stitch like this, and that makes a little circle, as you can see, in which we will start working right now, and we'll make 12 double crochets in there. To start with the first double crochet, we're going to make a chain 3 or chain 2, whatever you prefer. The pattern calls for a chain 3. I always like to do a chain 2, so I'll make a chain 2, and it's up to you what you think looks best. So I'll just chain 2 for my first double crochet, and now we're going to make 11 more double crochets. So it's yarn over, get your hook into that circle, in the center of that circle, make your first double crochet like this. As you can see, this first double crochet is a chain 2, and this is the first double crochet. You're going to make 10 more. Just get your hook in every time and make a double crochet. This is 3. Of course, it's a bit fiddly every time. When you start a project like this with thin yarn, the beginning is always fiddly, so I'm just going to take it out again because I like it to look neat. I've made 3 so far, so this is number 4. Six, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, and 12, like this. Just going to recount to make sure. One of the tips I'm going to give you as well is just keep on counting. Count every round, or at least every few rounds, because if you don't, your stitches will be off, your count will be off, and you will not be happy. So just keep counting and it will really help you in the process. So just count your double crochets. This is 1, and let me see, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, and 12. So I have 12 double crochets exactly as I wanted. And we're going to close with a slip stitch on the top of that of those chain 2 that we made in the beginning, or chain 3. So just get your hook in there like this, yarn through and through that loop as well. Now we've closed and we've made the first round of our jacaranda, and I'll see you for round 2. Round number 2. As you can see, I haven't worked away my tails yet. I'm going to do that in the next round because I don't like to work away tails or something that's so tiny. And we're going to start with color D, which is in my case the lila color. And we're going to start with a standing double crochet in any stitch. So I made a slip knot again. And we're just going to get into any stitch. I'm just going to start with this one and make a standing double crochet in there. I'll show you how to do that. You hold your finger on your loop and you yarn over like this. You get into that stitch that you chose and just finish off your double crochet, all the while holding that loop with your finger. This for me is the easiest way to make a standing double crochet. So just finish off your double crochet like this, still holding that loop. And now you're going to let go and pull through. So you made a standing double crochet in there. And you're going to make 3 double crochets into that same stitch. So just normal double crochets. Just make 3 more. It's 1, 2, and 3. So I have 4 double crochets into one stitch. Chain 1. I'm going to skip one stitch, the next stitch, which is this one. And then we're going to make 4 double crochets into the next stitch, which is this one. So we skip this one. And now we're working to this one and make 4 double crochets in there. 1, 2, 3, and 4. Chain 1, skipping one stitch, working to the next. Make 4 double crochets. 1, 2, 3, and 4. Chain one, skipping a stitch, working to the next. 1, 2, 3, and 4. Chain one, skipping one stitch, working to the next one. 1, 2, 3, and 4. Chain one, skipping this stitch, working into the next. 1, hook in and make double crochet. 1, 2, 3, and 4, like this. Chain one, and then we're going to close in the top of that first double crochet. So just get your hook in and slip stitch like this. And as you can see, this is the beginning of the little flower in the start. So you should have 24 double crochets in total and 6 chain one spaces, and of course also 6 petals. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. That's what you should have. Don't cut your yarn. We're going to continue with the same color in the next round. So we're going to continue with color D, and I'll see you for round 3. Round 3. As you can see, I haven't cut my yarn. I am going to continue with the same color. I recommend you do the same. And we're going to start with a chain 3. 1, 2, 3. And this is the first treble, because we're going to make treble 5 togethers in this round. And I'll show you how to start this particular first one, because it's going to be different from the rest. Then I'll also show you how to do the rest of the round. This you can consider the first leg of the treble 5 together. So we're going to, for the treble 5 together, we're going to yarn over twice like this, and we're going to go to the next stitch. This is the first stitch of those 4 double crochets. We're going to go to the second one, get your yarn in, and pull up a loop, and get your yarn through twice. So 1 and 2. So you're going to leave 2 loops like this, 2 loops on your hook, yarn over twice, next stitch, get your yarn, your hook in there, and pull through once, pull through twice, 3 loops on your hook, yarn over twice, to the last double crochet, pull through once, pull through twice, like this. 4 loops on your hook. Now we're going to do this one last time. Yarn over twice. This is a bit of a tricky part, because we're going to not work into this space. Not going to work in the space. We're going to work in the chain itself. We're going to look for those, for that little eye, that little hole in there. It's very difficult to see, but the thing is that you have to poke your yarn in, just really push through, and as an effect or as a result, you will have the 2 loops of the chain on the upside, and on the downside you'll have 1 little loop like this. So you're going to work into that chain stitch instead of the chain space itself. Don't worry, if you do it, you will see that it's quite clear and quite easy, but just poke your hook through and you should be fine. And get the yarn through. It's gonna be a little bit fiddly, as you can see. Again, pull through once, pull through twice, 5 loops on your hook, and then yarn over one last time and pull through all 5 at once. You can see that first little petal made very clearly. I'll show you a few more times so you can get used to this. We're going to chain 7. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. And we're going to go to the next petal, so this one over here. We're going to yarn over twice again, and this is the first complete treble 5 together that we're going to do. So yarn over twice, go to your first stitch. You can identify that by going to the chain space over here, looking for that first loop, so you don't get confused. Get your hook in, pull through once, and pull through twice. 2 loops on your hook. Yarn over twice. Next stitch, pull through once, pull through twice. 3 loops on your hook. Yarn over twice. Next stitch, pull through once, pull through twice. Yarn over twice, last stitch, yarn through once, yarn through twice. 5 loops on your hook. That's what it makes it different from the last, from the first beginning stitch, because we're going to make one more leg into that chain space, or that chain stitch again. So yarn over twice, look for that little eye that I was talking about. I don't know if you can see it, but it is over here. This is the eye that we are looking for. Just poke your hook through like this, and again, I hope you can see it. Just look at those 2 loops here and that 1 loop over here, and get your yarn through, which again can be a little bit fiddly, so just take care and pull through once and pull through twice. 6 loops on your hook. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Yarn over and pull through all 6. 2 petals made. Congratulations, you did something that's really quite different, quite hard, so just keep on going and I know you can do it. I'll show you one more time, because it really is a little bit tricky, but you can do it, I'm sure. So just chain 7, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and 7. Yarn over twice. Look for that first stitch. Pull through once and twice. 2 loops on your hook. Yarn over twice. Next stitch. Once, twice. 3rd stitch. Once, twice, and that last tricky one, just get your hook through, pull through once, pull through twice, and then pull through all 6 loops. 3 petals made. Like this. You have 3 more to go, so just make your chain 7 and your treble 5 together, And when you get to the end of the round, I want you to make a slip stitch on the top of this first petal. So if you can just look along with me, you've made your chain 7 here. Then you have like this has become one stitch. It's like it's become one stitch, and it has a top, and that's this. So if you can see it, there's the top of this stitch because it's become one stitch instead of 5 or 6 legs. It's become instead of 5 legs, it has become one stitch. This is the top of it, and that's where you place your slip stitch when you reach the end. And when you're at the end, just close with that slip stitch, and I will see you for round 4. Round number 4. I have a new color yarn on my hook, which is color B. And I'm going to start with a beginning or a standing single crochet into any chain 7 space. I'm just going to insert my hook into a space and make a standing single crochet like this. Going to make 3 more single crochets into that same space. So just make 3 more single crochets. 1, 2, and 3. Now we're going to make a treble in the chain 1 space of round 2, which is this chain 1 space. So we're going to yarn over twice, and we're going to insert our hook into that chain 1 space and work while your chain space is behind your work. So just go like this and finish your treble. Don't worry, I'll show you again in the next one. After you finish this treble, you're going to make 4 single crochets again into that same chain 7 space. So you've made 4 here, you're going to make 4 more. So it's just 1, 2, 3, and 4. Like this. Around this top of the treble 5 together, we're going to make a front post single crochet. Front post means that you insert your hook from the front to the back around the stitch like this, pick up your yarn, and make a normal single crochet. Finish it like any single crochet like this. This makes the petals more pronounced. That's the whole goal of it. I'll show you one more time. I'm going to make 4 single crochets into the chain 7 space. So 1, 2, 3, and 4. I'm going to make a treble. So yarn over twice. And go to that chain 1 space of round 2. Insert your hook like this. And get out of the other way. And leave your chain 7 at the back. And finish your treble as you would do normally, like this. Single crochet, 4 of them in the same chain 7 space, 3, 4, and a front post single crochet around that treble 5 together, like this. This is what your work should look like up till now. Don't worry if it bubbles a little bit. Mine does as well. Don't worry about it. It will get itself straight later. I'll show you one last time. The rest you can do yourself. Just make 4 single crochets. 1, 2, 3, and 4. Yarn over twice for your treble. Insert your hook make a treble like this four single crochets into the chain space, 3, 4, and a front post single crochet around that petal like this. This is what it should look like for now. Again, it will bubble a little bit, don't worry about it. It will pull itself straight in the next round. Go all the way around with your single crochets and your trebles. In the end, join with your first standing single crochet. And don't cut your yarn because we're going to use the same color for round 5. Round number 5. I didn't cut my yarn. The pattern calls for the same color, so I'm just going to continue with color B. And we're going to I'm first going to show you how I made my work this flat, because if you're working with the same yarn, especially and probably with any yarn, your work will be wobbly. Actually, this was so wobbly that in the beginning I didn't know if I was doing it right. Kept checking the pattern. What I did was I pulled my yarn out a little bit like this, so I wouldn't rip it all out. And then I pulled a bit like this, just with my hands, just pulled the stitches apart a little bit to give it some room, because it was all very tight together and it was all going like this, just pulling up, and that's not what you want, of course. So I just pulled all those stitches apart a little bit to get them to be distributed more evenly. As you can see now, it's laying quite flat, and I'm sure that if you do this as well, it will happen for you the same way. Now we're going to start with round 5, again with the same color that we were already working with. So we're going to start with a chain 1, like this. And then we're going to make a single crochet in the back loop only in the next 4 stitches. So this is the first, this chain 1 counts as the first single crochet in the back loop. So we're going to go to the next back loop, which is this one. Just insert your hook into the back loop only. So normally you work through, just get those stitches apart a little bit. As you can see, it's all very fiddly because the stitches are small, and it's just a really fine yarn as well. So just normally you would work through the whole stitch like this. In this case, we're not going to work through the whole stitch. We're going to work through the back loop only. So we're going to look for that back loop, and that is this one. Just through one loop, then make a single crochet in there. We're going to do the same for the next 3, so 4 back loop single crochets in total. This is 2, 3, and 4. Like this. 4 single crochets in the back loop only. Now we've arrived at the treble. The treble that we made into the chain space. We're going to make a front post half double crochet around this. So just yarn over and around the post of this treble, make a half double crochet. So yarn over and then pull through all 3 loops at once. Well, as usual, half double crochet is a little bit fiddly. So again, I'm going to pull this out, start over. So yarn over once, around that post, like this. Give yourself some room, I didn't do that last time. And pull through all 3 loops at once, like this. We're going to skip this stitch behind that half double crochet that we just made. And we're going to make a back loop single crochet into the next 9 stitches. So just get into that back loop like this. and make 9 single crochets in the back loop. This is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, more yarn, 6, 7, 8, this is 8, and 9, like this. And again, we've arrived at that treble over here, this treble. Again, we're going to make a half double crochet, a front post half double crochet around it. So from the front to the back, around the post, make a half double crochet, like this. As you can see, this half double crochet is extending this treble, which is making a nice line over here. I'll show you one last time. We're going to skip this stitch behind the treble. We're going to look for that first, this one, that first single crochet after it. So we're going to skip this one, working into this back loop. Make a single crochet. 2, 3, and so forth, like this. Continue this until the end of the round as usual. Close with a slip stitch on that first chain one that we made, and we're going to start with a new color in the next round, so you can cut your yarn. I'm going to work away. Oh no, I'm sorry, we're going to continue with the same yarn, excuse me. So don't cut your yarn after this round, we're going to continue with the same yarn, and I'll see you for round 6. Round number 6. I worked away my tails of yarn, and we're going to start in this round in any of the front post half double crochets. So that's this one, or this one, or this one. What I do in such situation, because you're using the same color yarn, is I'm going to slip stitch into that, or to that stitch. So I'm just going to work into back loops for these slip stitches, and I'm going to look for that first stitch that's after the stitch I'm in, and go into the back loop only and make a slip stitch. Then the next one, also the back loop only, like this, until you're at the point that you want to be. I prefer this above cutting my yarn and starting over again from the right point. It doesn't show when you work over it, because you did it only in the back loop, and it's just easier. I just find this an easier way, like this. Now I'm in the stitch before the half double crochet, or the front post half double crochet, and because we're going to start in this stitch, I'm not going to go into the back loop. I'm just going to take the full 2 loops and slip stitch into that. So again, where we're here, we did slip stitches in the back loops until the stitch before the half double crochet, and then I did a slip stitch into that front post half double crochet in both loops to get to the right point. And we're going to start by making a beginning cluster double crochet, and we do that by making a chain 2 for the first double. Going to finish this by working into the same stitch and then just making one more double crochet. This way you've made a beginning cluster. No, sorry, I made a mistake. Let me just do that again. Go to yarn over, work in the same stitch, yarn over once, and then get through all the loops at one time. This is your first beginning cluster two double crochet that we made. Then we're going to chain two, one, two, and make another cluster two double crochet in that same stitch. So yarn over, pull through two loops, yarn over, same stitch, pull through two loops, and then pull through all three remaining loops. So at this point we have created a little V, as you can see, a little V of two double crochets together into the same stitch, like this. To pick up my yarn again, I'm going to chain three, one, two, three. We're going to skip four stitches. We're just going to count one, two, three, and four. And into that fifth stitch, we're going to make another cluster two double crochet, chain two, cluster double crochet. So just make your first cluster like this, pull through two loops, and then yarn over, pull through all three loops, chain two, and make another cluster two double crochet like this. This single crochet that we're making, this cluster two double crochet, chain two, cluster two double crochet in, is the one that we made that was made into the front post single crochet of round four. So if you can see, this is that front post single crochet. This is the stitch made into it. So that this way you can always check if you're still at the right point, if you didn't make any counting mistakes. So keep checking your work so you don't regret it later. I always keep counting, because seriously, it's very easy, especially with this light or thin yarn, very easy to make a mistake. And of course, you don't want to have to rip out your work and start over again. We're going to continue what we're doing, what we already did at this point. We're going to chain three, one, two, three, count four stitches, one, two, three, four. And if your stitch count is correct, your fifth stitch should be the front post half double crochet of the previous round. So as you can see, my stitch count is correct. I can just make my next cluster in here. So just pull through once, pull through twice, and yarn over and all through all three loops, chain two, and another cluster in that same stitch, like this. This is the look that you're going for. I'll show you one last time, and then I'm sure you can do it on your own. Chain three. Count your stitches. One, two, three, four. In the fifth, make your cluster. Like this. Chain two. And the next cluster made. As you can see, they're all little V's of a cluster, clusters of the double crochets. You're going to continue this all the way around, and you're going to close at the second chain that you've made here at the top of this first chain two or chain three that you made. And I will see you for round seven after that, and we'll be using a new color yarn. So after this, you can cut your yarn and work away your tails, and we start with a different color. Round number seven. In this round, we're only going to work in the chain two spaces between the two clusters, or the two cluster two double crochets. So we're only going to work into these chain two spaces, not into the chain three spaces. I'll show you how to do it exactly. We're going to join with a beginning cluster three double crochets into any chain two space. And to do that, you hold your yarn like this, like I showed you before, yarn over, get into that space, and make the beginning of a double crochet. You're not going to finish it, you're going to keep those two loops on your hook. I'm going to yarn over, get into that same space, and pull through two loops. Yarn over, get into the same space, pull through two loops, four loops on your hook, and pull through all four loops at once. This is the first cluster three double crochet made. After that, we're going to chain two. And still working into that same space, we're going to make another cluster three double crochet. Yarn over, pull through two loops, yarn over, pull through two loops, yarn over, pull through two loops, yarn over, pull through four loops, like this. Chain two, and again, make another cluster. Pull through two loops, yarn over, pull through two loops, yarn over, and pull through two loops, yarn over, pull through four loops. This is the look you're going for. So we have three clusters like this with a chain two in between. Now, to bridge the gap to the next chain two space, we're going to chain five. One, two, three, four, and five. And we're going to just repeat what we did here as well. For this particular start, I'm going to hold this loop again as a tip, because if you don't, then it goes everywhere and it's harder to work. Just hold this loop for the first stitch. Yarn over, get into that chain two space, yarn over and pull through two loops. Now you can let go of this loop if you want, so it's not going to go anywhere everywhere. And just finish your cluster like we did before. Like this. Chain two. Make another cluster in the same space. Chain two. And another third cluster. Like this. This is what you're going for. So basically, we're going to make three cluster three double crochets in every chain two and chain five in between to bridge the gap. So in the end, you'll have 36 cluster three double crochets. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, etc., until you're at the end at 36. And you're going to have 24 chain two spaces, and you're going to have 12 chain five spaces, and just continue until the end, and of course just end with a slip stitch into your first double crochet, and then I'll see you for round eight. Of course, there was round seven. I'm going to see you for round eight. Round number eight. This round is a little bit complicated at first, but when you get the hang of it, I assure you will be fine. Especially with the video, you should be able to do it easily. And as you can see, I made all my clusters, and it may feel a little bit like there's too many stitches, especially with all the chain five spaces. But don't worry, everything will come out great in the end. Like in the beginning when it was a little bit bobbly, as you can see now it's nice and flat. So this will also happen with all this. That seems like an extra space. So what I will do is I'm going to start in any chain 2 space between the first 2 clusters. So I'll show you which that is. You have these 3 clusters here and 2 chain 2 spaces. We're going to work in that first chain 2 space. So we're going to yarn over twice, hold that first loop like I showed you in the beginning, get into that first space and make a treble, a normal treble, like this. That's your first treble made. I'm going to get some yarn. Yes. Okay. After that, we're going to make another 4 trebles into that same chain 2 space. So just yarn over twice and make 4 more treble crochets. So we're going to make 5 in total, like this. Five trebles into the same space. We're going to skip this whole cluster and we're going to work in that next chain 2 space, so the second chain 2 space of those clusters, and make 5 trebles in there, exactly like you did in the previous chain 2 space. Just make 5 trebles. Three, four, and 5, like this. As you can see, it's a nice kind of shell that you made, and it will get even rounder when we finish this whole round. After those 5 trebles that you made, you're going to chain two. And we're going to make a popcorn stitch in the chain 3 space of round 6. Is this space. And we're going to work behind this chain 5 space of round 7. I'll show you how to do that. What you're going to do is you're going to fold your work ahead a little bit, like this, so you can reach this chain 3 space. And you're going to start with a double crochet in there, like this. See how we're working behind this chain 5? This is on purpose. And you're going to make, for a popcorn, we're making 5 double crochets, so we're going to make 4 more. 2, 3, 4, and 5, like this. I'm going to pull up your loop a little bit and insert your finger. This is how I do it, like this. This way you're securing the yarn. And you're going to get into the first double crochet that you made with your hook, like this. Grab that loop that I was holding on to, like this. And pull that loop through that first double crochet. See how this is your first popcorn made. To close the popcorn, make a chain 1. This way you've closed the popcorn. I know it might have seemed very complicated, especially for people who aren't very experienced. I'll show you one more time, and I'm sure you'll get the hang of it. It really isn't that hard once you know what to do. We're going to chain 2 again. So between every shell and popcorn is a chain 2, so it's shell, chain 2, popcorn, chain 2, and then a shell again to keep clear what your rhythm is. Now we're going to work into that chain 2 space again. I'm going to make 5 trebles in there. 1, 2, 3. A bit of a yarn knot here. 4, 5, 5 treble crochets. Make another 5 trebles in the next chain 2 space. 2, 3, 4. And 5, like this, chain 2, and we're going to make the popcorn again. I'll show you how to do it again. Yarn over, fold your work to the front, get into that chain 3 space of round 6, and make your first double crochet of the popcorn, like this. Make 4 more, all working behind that chain 5 space of the previous round. There's 4, 5 double crochets. Pull up your loop, put your finger in to hold it, or do it any way that you are comfortable with, of course, but for me this is the most easy and comfortable way. Look for that first double crochet, insert your hook, pull up that loop, or get the loop on your hook, and pull that loop through to form a popcorn, and close with a chain 1. So this chain 1 is not part of the pattern, it won't be mentioned separately, but the best way to close a popcorn is to close it with a chain 1. It will be behind the popcorn just to make it nice and closed. And then you're going to chain 2 for the pattern again, and so forth. You're going to make a shell in every cluster or 3 clusters that you have, like this, and a popcorn in every chain 3 space of round 6. And your loops, your chain 5 loops, you can pull them like this, so they're above the popcorn stitches. This will look nicest in the pattern, and this is also why we have a chain 5. Even though it looks very big and many stitches, you have this so it looks nice around the popcorns. Just keep going stitch by stitch until you have done all your popcorns and all your little shells, until you're at the end of the round, of course. Join with a slip stitch on your shell. And then I will see you for round 9. Round 9, I'm going to start with color C, which in my case is a deep purple. And this is a relatively easy round once you get the hang of it, so I'll just show you. We're going to join with a starting or standing or beginning front post double crochet around any popcorn, and we're going to be working in front of this chain 5 space. So I'll show you how to do that. Just hold this loop with your finger, yarn over, go around this popcorn like this, and make a double front post double crochet like this. That's your first front post double crochet made. We're going to skip this chain 2 space, and we're going to front post double crochet around the next 10 stitches, which is going to be quite easy once you get the hang of it. These are the stitches we're going to be working in into that shell. We're going to go in from the front around the post to the back and make double crochet. This is a front post double crochet. It's like an extension of the stitch. We're going to do this for all those trebles. A front post double crochet around every one of them. Of course, you're going to make 10 in total because there are 10 trebles, 5 in the first chain 2 space and 5 in the second one. Just make your double crochets like this. Two more. There you go. Like this. This is the look that you're going for. Now we're at the popcorn stitch again. We'll yarn over again and go into the from the front to the back, around the popcorn in front of the chain 5 space, make the front post double crochet. So basically, in this round, you're only going to make front post double crochets. We're going to make one around each popcorn and one around every treble. So in total, you're going to make 11 front post double crochets per section. And you're going to do this all the way around. So there's no real difference in stitches here, just all front post double crochets. Repeat this until you're at the end of the round. Join at your first front post double crochet. Don't cut your yarn because we're going to continue with the same color for the next round. And then I'll see you for round 10. Again, I made the same mistake. Round 10. I'm going to see you for round 10. Round number 10. Going to continue with the same color, and we're going to start with the first front post double crochet of the group of 10. So at this point, you're at the double crochet, front post double crochet that's around the popcorn. We need to start over here, and we're going to do that by making a front post single crochet around that first front post double crochet. So I'll show you how to do that. Just from where you are, put your needle, your hook in from the front to the back, around that post, and make a single crochet. Chain two. This counts as your first front post double crochet. This is a neat way of making a front double crochet this way. We're going to mark this chain space when we made our first stitch, our first coming stitch. We're going to make a front, so this counts as your first front post double crochet. Next, we're going to make a front post double crochet two together in the next two stitches. It sounds like a lot. It also sounds very difficult. It is not. I'll show you how to do it. I'm going to yarn over once. Insert your hook from the front to the back. Cat coming into the picture. Get off. Off. Get off. Sorry about that. You're going to show you again. Yarn over. Go in from the front to the back. Pull up your loop. And not finish your double crochet. You're going to leave two loops on the hook. Yarn over, go to your next front post double crochet, pull through two loops, like this, three loops on your hook, yarn over, and pull through all three loops. Again, it's a mouthful, it seems like it's very difficult, but it really isn't. So I'll show you again, don't worry, it will be quite easy when you do it. The next four stitches, we're going to make a front post double crochet. So just like we did the past round as well, just make a front post double crochet around each of these front post double crochets. This is 3. A little bit more yarn. Just look back. This was our front post double crochet two together. So this is 1, 2, 3 front post double crochets, and 1/4 one like this. Now you should have 3 front post double crochets left, and in those 3 we're going to make 1 front post double crochet two together, and 1 front post double crochet. So in the first 2 we're going to make a front post double crochet two together, insert your hook, pull through 2 loops, insert your hook on through the next stitch, pull through 2 loops, 3 loops on your hook, and pull through all 3 loops. That's your second double crochet, front post double crochet two together. And in the last front post double crochet, we're going to make a front post double crochet like this. So I'll show you, I'll tell you once more. It's 1 front post double crochet, 1 front post double crochet two together, 4 front post double crochets, 1 front post double crochet two together, and a front post double crochet. That's what we're doing in this shell. After that, we're making a chain 2, and we're going to skip this stitch, this front post double crochet that's around the popcorn. And in this little shell, we're going to repeat the same that we did before. I'll show you one last time, if the cat will let me. We're going to start with a front post double crochet. Then we're making a front post double crochet two together around the next 2 front post double crochets, like this. A front post double crochet into each of the next 4 stitches, 2, 3, and 4. A front post double crochet two together in the next, over the next 2 stitches. This, and lastly we're making a front post double crochet around the last double crochet, front post double crochet, chain 2 to cross the gap of this stitch, and vice versa. We're going to continue doing what we did throughout the whole round. As you can see, it's starting to look like a very pretty flowery kind of pattern. Just continue what we did all the way around. And forgot to mark my stitch. I'll show you how to do that. So here we made our chain 2. Remember, we made the single crochet, and then we chain 2 to make our first, or simulate our first front post double crochet. So I'm just going to mark that chain 2. Don't forget to do that. It really will help to see where your last stitch will go, because when you're done, when you're all the way around, you're going to not end with a slip stitch. You're going to end with a single crochet in this chain 2 space. And that's to make the next round go smoothly and nicely. So instead of a slip stitch, you're making a single crochet into this chain 2 space at the end of the round. And when you're done with that, I will see you for round 11. Don't cut off your yarn. We're going to continue with the same color. Round 11, I'm going to continue with the same color. As you can see, I ended with this single crochet into that chain 2 space. Now I'm going to take out that stitch marker, because we're going to use it again this round for the same reason. We're going to just stay where we are and make a chain 2 like this. And that is your first front post double crochet in the first front post double crochet. Okay, so this is your first, counts as your first front post double crochet. In this round, we're basically going to continue as we did the previous round, only the order of the stitches will be different a little bit. I'll show you how to do that. So we made our first front post double crochet. And then we're going to make a front post double crochet two together around the next front post double crochet two together, and also around the next front post double crochet. Now, this is even more of a mouthful than past round, but believe me, again, when I show you, you'll see that it's not hard. We're going to insert our hook from the front to the back around that front post double crochet two together of the previous round, around both stems like this, and make our front post double crochet two together like we did previous round, only we start around that double crochet two together. So just yarn over for the next front post double crochet, yarn over through two loops, three loops on your hook, and pull through like this. Now, before we continue, we're going to put the stitch marker into that chain two space so that we don't lose it, like this. There you go. And after this front post double crochet two together, we're going to make a front post double crochet around the next two double front post double crochets. So like that's why I said it's exactly the same as the past round, only the order we do things in is a bit different, but that's the only thing. So just make a front post double crochet around the next two front post double crochets. Then make a front post double crochet two together around the next front post double crochet and around this front post double crochet two together from the previous round. So just go around the stem of that front post double crochet, then around those two legs of the front post double crochet two together, and finish your front post double crochet two together. And we make front post double crochet around that last front post double crochet like this. Again, I told you before, it's more of a mouthful than it is hard, so just keep on going stitch by stitch and you'll find a rhythm. Chain two, single crochet into that chain two space, and chain two. And then we're back to the next cycle of double front post double crochets two togethers and front post double crochets. I'll show you one last time. So we start with a front post double crochet around the first front post double crochet. Then a front post double crochet two together around this front post double crochet two together and this front post double crochet like this. A front post double crochet around the next two front post double crochets, one and two. A front post double crochet two together around this next front post double crochet and the front post double crochet two together after it. This and a front post double crochet around that last front post double crochet. Chain two, single crochet into the chain space and chain two. This is what you're going to do this round. You're going to do this all the way around again, and just like the previous round, we're going to start with a single crochet in the chain two space of the beginning stitch. So just make a single crochet to end here, and don't cut your yarn, because again in round 12 we're going to continue with the same color. Round number 12. Going to basically continue the same road again. I'll show you how to do this round. But as I said, it's going to be a repeat of basically what we already did as for the techniques. So you shouldn't have too much of a hard time. We're going to remove the stitch marker again, like this. And we're going to again put that in the first chain two space of this round that we're going to make. So we're just going to chain two and make a front post double crochet two together around the next front post double crochet two together and around the next front post double crochet. So this is the front post double crochet two together, and this is the front post double. Just going to make a front post double crochet two together around those two stitches, like this. There you go. We're going to make a front post double crochet front post double crochet two together around the next front post double crochet and around the front post double crochet two together. So same thing. Going to go around this front post double crochet, not finish your double crochet, go around the front post double two together and finish your stitch like this, and make a front post double crochet around that last front post double crochet like this. As you can see, we're sharpening up those edges, making a flowery kind of bud here over here. After this last front post double crochet, we're going to do a chain two, one, two, a single crochet into this first chain two space, chain two, a single crochet into that second chain two space, chain two, and that's when our repeat starts again. So I'll show you one last time. Front post double crochet around that first front post double crochet, front post double crochet two together around that first front post double crochet two together and the next front post double crochet like this, a front post double crochet two together around the front post double crochet and the next front post double crochet two together like this, and in the last front post double crochet make a front post double crochet, chain two, single crochet into that first chain two space, chain two, single crochet into that second chain two space, chain two, and the cycle repeats again. So, this is what your work will look like when you're doing all these stitches. Don't forget to put your stitch marker where you started. See, I can already need to look where I started. It's over here. Here we are. That's where I started. This was the last single crochet I made. So I'm just going to put this stitch marker over here, so I know where to end. And of course we're ending again with a single crochet into that chain two space for the next round. Again, don't cut off your yarn because we're going to be using the same yarn for round 13. Round number 13. I removed the stitch marker from the chain two space and we're going to start with a chain one for some height. And then a front post double crochet around this next front post double crochet two together, like this. And in addition to some height, it also creates the first front post double crochet two together for us. Now we're going to put that stitch marker in that chain one space, to not lose it, like this. And we're going to make a front post double crochet two together around the front post double crochet two together and the last front post double crochet. So I'll show you. This is the front post double crochet two together, and this is the last double front post double crochet. Around that front post double crochet two together and around that last front post double crochet, make a front post double crochet two together. Well, I have to tell you, I know that this is starting to be a mush of stitches. I know there's lots of stitches here, and because it's thin yarn, it's not going to all be that clear. But if you keep track of your stitches and keep counting, you should be able to find everything. Just keep your eyes open and you should be fine. So just follow the pattern or this video and you should be okay. Well, we just made this last front post double crochet two together. We're going to chain three, make a single crochet into this next chain two space, chain two, make a single crochet into the next chain two space, chain two, and another single crochet into the last chain two space, chain three, make a front post double crochet two together around that first front post double crochet and the front post double crochet two together, so like this. Go and do the same for the next front post double crochet two together and the last front post double crochet, like this. There you go. Chain three, single crochet into that first chain two space, chain two, single crochet into the second chain two space, chain two, and single crochet into that third chain two space, chain three. That's your repeat. As you can see, these little buds are very, very nicely forming. You can see this nice edging from how you did the front post double crochets and the front post double crochet two togethers. So just continue this all the way around, and we're going to end not with a single crochet in this chain one. We're going to end with a slip stitch in the first front post double two together, and I'll show you where that is. And that is at the top of this stitch, is where I would connect it. So it's basically the top of that front post double crochet that we made after the chain one. I think that ends the best way. And when you've done that, I will see you for round 14. Round number 14. As you can see, I ended in this first double crochet two together, front post double crochet two together. And we're going to basically just work into these chain spaces that we made the previous round. So we're going to skip all of those double crochets two togethers, and we're going to work only into those spaces, and I'll show you how we're going to do that. First, we're going to slip stitch into that first chain space. Just go through that back loop of that first or the second front post double crochet two together, and then into that chain space like this. Now we're at the right position, and we're going to immediately make a single crochet into that same space, like this. Chain three, go to the next chain space, make single crochet, chain three, go to the next chain space, make a single crochet, chain three, and single crochet into the next chain space, chain 3. Now we're at the front post, double crochet two togethers, those two. So we're basically going to just finish off the little flower bud right now. We're going to skip those and work into that first chain space, after that a single crochet, chain 3, and single crochet into the next chain space, chain 3, single crochet, chain 3, single crochet, chain 3, and skipping those two front post double crochets, and so forth. That's basically all there is to this round. It looks more complicated than it is, like most of the rounds that we've done so far, but especially this round, it really is just a matter of working into the chain 2 spaces, making a single crochet in there, and making a chain 3, and just skipping all of the front post double crochet two togethers. And when you're done with this round, you're just going to slip stitch into that first single crochet that we made. So that's the single crochet we made into that first chain space that we slip stitched into. And when you're done, you can cut your yarn, because we're going to use a different color for the next round. And then I'll see you for round 15. Round 15. In this round, we're going to make the overlay crochet around these petals. I'll show you how to do that. The pattern is quite wordy, and that's because, yeah, it really all needs to be mentioned separately. But in the end, it's not going to be very hard. If you just pay attention, you should be able to do it. First, I would like you to take a moment to take a look at the anatomy of your stitches, especially with the Alisa Diva yarn. It might be hard to see the stitches, especially in a darker color like I have here. And I'll show you where we're going to work in. So first of all, the start will always be at the stitches above the popcorn. So you can see here the front post double crochet around that popcorn. That's the round we're going to start in. And we're going to begin our work with this front post double crochet before the popcorn, this front post double crochet around the popcorn, and this front post double crochet after the popcorn. That's the first stitch. I'll show you how to do them in a bit. After you've done this stitch, you're going to move up to this front post double, this one. So that's the one right above this one that we worked in with the first stitch, this front post double crochet. After that, we're going to work into this front post double crochet, and after that, we're going to work into this front post double crochet. And the last stitch we'll do to finish this whole line will be the outer leg of this front post double crochet two together, this one. As you can see, this is a front post double crochet two together, and we're going to work into this leg. After that, we'll be working into the second front post double crochet two together of these two. So this is considered the first one, this one is considered the first one, and this one is considered the second one. And in that case, we're going to work into this stitch. So basically, it's the top of the petal. Now, it sounds all very difficult, but seriously, when you start doing it, you'll be fine. And for the purpose of this video, I will use white to make the stitches as clear as possible. But after I'm done taping this video, I will do it again with my color E, which is a darker color, which will look nice, but for the video it's better to do it with white. I'm just going to show you with the white yarn. Get the yarn on your hook. Again, as I said before, we're going to start with these front post double crochets before, after, and around the popcorn. So just insert your hook like this. And we're going to make a front post single crochet three together. Show you how to do that. We pulled up these two loops. I'm not going to do anything with them. I'm going to go immediately to the front post double crochet that's around the popcorn. Pull up that loop. Three loops on your hook. And to the next front post double crochet that's after the popcorn. Pull up that loop. Now you have four loops on your hook. Yarn over and pull through all four loops at once, like this. This is a front post single crochet three together. Now we're going to work into those stitches of the outer line of the petal, and we're not going to work like this. We're going to be working like this, so from the inside of the petal to the outside, always. So at this point, from this side, we're going to work like this, and at the other side, we'll be working like this. I'll show you how to do that. I'm going to go to the next front post double crochet, which is this one, and first we're going to make a chain one. You always need some height to get to the next stitch, so between every stitch that you make and the next one is going to be a chain one, just remember that. So chain one, get to your next front post double crochet and make a single crochet, chain one. Our next double crochet is over here, make a single crochet and chain one. Our next front post double crochet is here, make a single crochet and chain one. And now we're not working into a front post double crochet, but into the leg, the right or the outer leg of the front post double crochet two together that we did. So that's this leg. And make a single crochet with a chain one, again for height. Now we're at the top of the petal. This is our first front post double crochet two together. This is our second one. And this is if you would work into the first one, then you would work into these two loops. This one, these two. But we're not going to work into that one, we're going to work into the second one, which is quite clear. We're going to make a single crochet in there. Then a half double crochet into that same stitch, and then another single crochet. This is how we make a little bit of pointy end to our flower petal. And now we're going to do exactly the same as we go down. I'll show you how to do that. First, we're going to chain one. Again, for height, this time we're going downwards. But to get to these next stitches, you always need a chain one in between. And the first stitch we're going to make is going to be a single crochet into the outer leg of this front post double crochet two together, which is this leg. You make a single crochet in there, like this. Chain one. Now we're going to make three single crochets into the front post double crochets, all above each other. So single crochet, chain one, move one downwards, single crochet, chain one, and the last one, single crochet, and one last chain one. Now we're at the point where we're going to make the front post single crochet three together again. So like we did in the beginning of the round. and that goes like this again. Just insert your hook, pull up the loop, go to your next stitch that's around the popcorn, pull up that loop, and the front post double crochet after it, pull up a loop, yarn over, and pull through all four loops. This is the look that we are going for. So as you can see, we started here above this popcorn. We worked our way upwards, working from the inside of the petal to the outside, so from here to here. When we were here, we did a single crochet, half double crochet, single crochet. And we worked our way backwards, also working from the center of the petal to the outside, until we're here and made our single crochet, front post single crochet three together. And between every stitch we make, there's a chain one, so we can get to the other point. I'll show you another time. So we made our single crochet three together. Going to chain one for height again. Work into that next front post double crochet, which is this one. Make a single crochet, chain one, move to our next front post double crochet, make a single crochet and chain one, move to our next single crochet, chain one. Now we've arrived at our front post double crochet two together. I'm going to work into the outer leg of this one, make a single crochet, chain one. Now working again into that second double front post double crochet two together. Just work into the stitch, not around the stitch. Make a single crochet, half double crochet, and a single crochet like this. Now we're at the top again, going downwards, working into that outer leg of that front post double crochet two together, make single crochet, chain one, moving downwards, single crochet, chain one, moving downwards again, single crochet, chain one, and one last time, single crochet and chain one. Now you're again at the point where you're going to make the single crochet, the front post single crochet three together. Work around the stitch, pull up a loop, work around the stitch that's around the popcorn, pull up a loop, and into the stitch that's after the popcorn, pull up that loop again, and work through all three stitches, loops, or four loops, sorry. So this is what your work should look like at this point. As you can see, we're making very pretty overlay definitions of the flower petal. Work your way around, as usual. And when you're at the end, just finish with a slip stitch on your first single crochet, or your first front post single crochet three together, and pull your yarn to the back. Work away your tails as neatly as possible. And now we've done this quite complicated round. I'll see you for round 16. Round number 16. We're going to be working into round 14. So this was round 15. Of course, we're not going to be working in there, especially except for one stitch. I'll show you how to do that. But mostly we're just going to be working into round 14 and into these chain 2 spaces and chain 3 spaces, which are right above the tip of those V's. And we're going to start in any of the chain 3 spaces that's after the tip. So here you have the point of the petal. This is the chain space above it. This is the chain space we're going to work into. to join with a standing single crochet, like this, and make three more single crochets in that same space. Three and four. Skipping the single crochet, working into the next chain two space, make four single crochets. Two, three, and four. Next chain space, make also four single crochets. One, two, three, and four. Now we're at the chain three space above the tip of the petal. In that we're going to make first two single crochets. One, two. Now we want to connect this tip of the petal to your work so it's nice and pointy. And to do that we're going to make a back post half double crochet around the half double crochet of this round 15. So just pull apart your work a little bit. You can see you have a single crochet, half double crochet, and another single crochet. You're going to be looking for the stem of the half double crochet. So this is the stem of the single crochet. So the second one is the half double crochet. And we've done a lot of front post double crochets and half double crochets. This time we're going from the back because it's a back post half double crochet. And we're going to insert our hook from the back to the front around that stem. And we're going to make a half double, back post half double crochet in there. I just didn't yarn over, so I need to do it again. Again, look for your stitch, yarn over, keep your yarn a little bit tight so you can work. There's your stitch, from the back to the front, around that stitch, pull up your loops and finish off your back post half double crochet like this. As you can see, the result is a nice pointy end of your petal. I'll show you one more time over here. In that same space that we made two single crochets in already for round 14, we're going to make one more single crochet. Like this. And now we're at our the beginning of our repeat again. Or we're going to continue the pattern that as we started it before. We're going to make four single crochets in every chain two space. Just two, three, four. One, two, three, four, yes. Four into the next space. Two, three, and four. Four into the next space. One, two, three, and four. Now we're again at the chain three. I'm going to make two single crochets in there. Then we're going to look for that half double crochet again. Yarn over. Pull away your stitches from each other. Get in from the back to the front around your half double crochet. And finish your stitch like this. This is what it should look like. As you can see, the ends are nice and pointy now. I'm going to do this for all the petals and all the chain spaces. And in the end, we're going to close with a slip stitch on your first single crochet that you've made. And you're going to cut your yarn because we're going to continue with another color in the next round. Round number 17. This is quite a relaxing round. You'll be happy to know this because you've had a few really complicated rounds, of course. And we're just going to make half double crochets and chain once in this round. I'll show you how to do a bit of it. In this round, we're working into the second and fourth single crochets every time. So, I'm going to start. This is the first single crochet of our group of four. We'll start into the second, this second single crochet, like this. Hold this loop to make your beginning or standing half double crochet and finish your half double crochet like this. Chain one, skip this third single crochet, work a half double crochet into that next stitch. Chain one, skipping a stitch. This is the first of the group of four. Work into that second stitch, half double crochet, like this. Chain one, skipping this stitch, and working into the fourth stitch, a half double crochet. Chain one, skipping a stitch. Half double crochet, chain one, skip a stitch, make a half double crochet, chain one, skipping this stitch, working to the next one, chain one, skipping a stitch, working into this last single crochet of the point, like this. So basically, we're working into the second and fourth of each group of four. And then we're working into the second single crochet of the three single crochets that we made into the chain three. So we're skipping the first, working into the second. We're skipping the front post half double crochet that's around this tip. And then we're working again into that third single crochet over here. That's basically all there is to it. So if you're going to look at it simply, you're starting into the second single crochet of any group of four. And you're working half double crochet, skip a stitch, chain one, half double crochet. That's all there is to this round. It really is a very relaxing, a very easy round. When you're done with your round, close with a slip stitch on your first half double crochet, and I'll see you for round 18. Round 18. We're going to be working double crochets and chain once, and we're going to do those alternating in front and behind of the chain. The chain ones that we made the previous round. I'll show you how to do that. Beginning, you'll have to get the hang of it a little bit. Once you have, it's not going to be hard. We're going to start in any tip of at any tip of the flower petal, and we're going to start with a double crochet into this skip stitch. So this back post half double crochet, but we're going to do it behind the chain space of round 17. So we're going to hold our fingers to hold the loop and then not go into the stitch like this, but from the back. Cat loves crochet. We're going to make a double crochet into that stitch, and we're going to fold our work to the front a little bit. Get your hook into that back post half double crochet and make a double crochet like this. So you can see the chain space, the chain one, is in front of our double crochet. You'll see the effects of that in a little bit. And as I said, we're going to alternate. So we're going to make another double crochet. First we're going to make a chain one. And then another double crochet. And instead of doing this to the back again, like we did the previous stitch, we're going to do this to the front. In front of that chain one space, like this. Like this. Chain one. And we're back to the back. So just get into that stitch, that skipped stitch of round 16, but keep your chain space to the front, and you've made another double crochet behind your chain space. Chain one. Now it's the turn time to go back to the front, make a double crochet in there, and chain one. So you can see a little bit how this will look when you're done. I'll make a few more stitches to show you how it will really look, and then you can do the rest yourself. Okay, just keep alternating, working into those skipped stitches, once at the back, once at the front. Beginning is going to be a little bit fiddly until you figure out a way to do those stitches. So don't worry, it's not very hard, just needs some concentration in the beginning. Like this. Make two more. Like this. Okay. Now you can see what your work will look like. The one that on the back will disappear a little bit, but it will show through the little gap that's here, and the other ones of course will show on the front, which will make a very nice stripey kind of pattern. Do this all the way around until you're at the end of your round 18. You close with a slip stitch as usual. Don't cut your yarn because we're going to do one last round for this part. So I'll see you for round 19. Round number 19. We finished all our double crochets and chain ones. And we're in for a very, very, very easy round, especially compared to what we did the previous 18 rounds. And we're just going to make a single crochet into every stitch and into every chain one space all around, all through the round. So to do this, start with a chain one. And I work a single crochet into that same stitch that I'm in, like this. Now we're at the chain space, we're just going to work a single crochet into the chain space. And into the next double crochet. Single crochet into the chain space and single crochet into the next double crochet. Single crochet into the chain space and single crochet into the next double crochet. And that's all there is to this round. Just going to make a single crochet into every stitch, every double crochet and every chain space. You should end up with 192 stitches. I would advise you to count your stitches at this point, make sure you're still okay, but if you count it in the meantime, you should be fine. And this concludes the Jacaranda Crochet Along Part 1. I hope you enjoyed doing this with us. Hope you enjoyed making the nice little overlay patterns, and I will see you for part 2 next week, and have a great crochet day.